Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston Station, we are ready for the event.
ACR, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is Houston ACR. How do you hear me?
Hear you loud and clear.
Got you loud and clear as well. Please stand by for opening remarks.
Hello, astronauts aboard the International Space Station and viewers during this in-flight education downlink. My name is Lisa Roberts, and I'm the superintendent of the Boise School District. On behalf of our district, it's my absolute honor to welcome you and thank you for taking the time to connect with our students at Hawthorne Elementary School and other students across Idaho. This is a truly extraordinary opportunity for our learners, and we are all beyond excited to be a part of this unique experience. I want to give special recognition to Dr. Kelly Taylor, a dedicated third grade teacher at Hawthorne, whose vision and hard work made this possible. Through her leadership and the support of her administrator and colleagues at Hawthorne Elementary, she has inspired students to reach for the stars, literally and figuratively. To the students, this is your chance to learn from real pioneers of space exploration. You're about to interact with people who embody curiosity, perseverance, and innovation. Let today spark your own dreams and remind you that the sky is not the limit. It's just the beginning. Thank you again to the astronauts for sharing your time and stories with us. Your visit will make a lasting impact, inspiring our students to explore, question, and aspire to great things. Safe travels, and we look forward to learning from you.
Hi, I'm Lola, and I'm in 3K.
Hi, my name is Cyrus, and I'm in third grade and at Hawthorne Elementary. We have the same questions. What do you do for fun on the International Space Station, and do you play video games?
During off-duty time on Space Station, I like to do things that you can't do on Earth. So playing video games and watching TV and things like that you could do on Earth, and I'll do that when I get back after this mission. But here, I'm going to spend time doing photography out the windows and doing investigations in zero gravity.
Hi, I'm Camilla from Hawthorne Elementary, 6th grade.
Hi, I'm Bennett in 1st grade gate, Hawthorne Elementary. We had similar questions. Can astronauts bring any personal items from their home to the ISS? How do astronauts store their supplies?
We could bring a small bag about the size of a backpack of personal items to Space Station so long as they pass all the NASA safety reviews. And the kind of supplies that I like to bring are things that I could do scientific observations with.
Hi, I'm Clara in 2nd grade Hawthorne Elementary.
Hi, I'm Lily, 2nd grade Hawthorne Elementary.
Hi, I'm Chloe, 6th grade Hawthorne Elementary.
Where I'm a guinea pig and we do experiments on ourselves and we do other biological experiments like on plants and things like that. And then we do physical experiments on combustion and crystal growth and things like that, chemistry. So we do all kinds of experiments on station.
Hi, I'm Sawyer from Hawthorne Elementary. I'm 3rd grade. Is it easy to walk in a 280-pound spacesuit in space?
We can walk around with a 280-pound spacesuit without any trouble when we are in orbit because it doesn't have any weight. It has mass, but it doesn't have weight. And when you get to science class in school, you will learn about the differences between mass and weight.
Hi, my name is Eleanor, and I'm in fourth grade at Hawthorne Elementary. What made you want to become an astronaut, and was this a dream of yours as a kid?
I wanted to become an astronaut ever since I was like in the fifth grade or fourth grade. And I saw John Glenn go into orbit, and I thought, wow, that's cool. And then I studied all the fun things in school, math and science, and at university, engineering. And these are the kinds of things you need to have understanding of when you fly into space.
Hi, my name is Ivy. I am in fifth grade. I was wondering, what is the most amazing thing you have seen while looking out the space station?
One of the most amazing things you could look at is our planet, planet Earth. And you could see all kinds of geology. You could see mountains and mountain ranges. You could see deserts. You could see oceans. You could see the effect of weather and geology all by looking out at Earth.
My name is Chloe. I'm a fifth grader at Hawthorne Elementary. And my question for you guys is, what is the most surprising thing you have learned about yourself while you were on the International Space Station?
One of the things I have learned about going into space is how resilient human beings are, including myself, in being away from normal civilization.
Hi, my name is Isaac. I'm in second grade from Hawthorne Elementary. How old were you when you first wanted to learn about space?
I was about 8 years old when I first decided that I wanted to become an astronaut.
Hi, my name is Avery, and I was wondering if you guys were able to grow any plants up there.
Yes, we can grow plants on space station. We have a special piece of equipment called plant habitat, and it's just about 10 feet away from where I am right now, and we are currently growing lettuce. And not lettuce for people to eat, but lettuce because of the research you could do with it. You can look at the biome. You can look at all the microorganisms that hitch a ride on the roots and the leaves of the lettuce, and that is the point of this particular study.
Hi, my name is Bria, and my question is, what is your favorite place in the space station?
My favorite place on space station is a module called the cupola. And it has seven windows that are arranged in a hemisphere, so it's like a big bubble, and you can stick your head in there and look out at not only space, but on planet Earth.
How much of the Milky Way can you see from the space station?
We could see all of the Milky Way, all in a single orbit. However, right now the Milky Way is in conjunction with the sun, so we can't see much of it at all. But come springtime, the Milky Way will be opposite from the sun, and then we will be able to see the Milky Way.
My name is Cruz. My question is, which spacecraft did you go to the space station on?
I have flown to space station on two different kinds of spacecraft. I flew on the space shuttle launching from Kennedy Space Center, and I've flown here twice on that, and I've flown twice to space station on the Russian Soyuz spacecraft.
Hi,
My name is Marin, and my question for you is, how long do you have to train before you can go on a space mission?
Once you have done the basic astronaut training, you train about 2 years for a specific mission, and you're training full-time, so that 2 years is about equivalent to going and getting another college degree, another four-year college degree.
Hi, my name is Jonas Quast, and my question for you is, when crystallizing pharmaceutical compounds, how do you know when you've made a new crystal? And are crystals grown in microgravity better for studying compounds' properties than those grown on Earth?
Oh, that's a good question. I could talk about that for maybe an hour. I think we're going to have to do that another time. But short answer to your question, the basic crystal structure is unchanged in microgravity versus growing on Earth. However, the morphology can be different. The morphology, the habit that the crystal ends up taking. And for example, edges may grow faster in microgravity than faces. So you get a different morphology than if faces grow faster than edges.
Hi, my name is Mason, and my question is, with there being so many jobs that astronauts are doing on the International Space Station, how do you choose your specific jobs during your time there?
When you are an astronaut, you really don't choose your job. Part of the 2 years of training that you do as an astronaut is to learn all the different operations that you could possibly do during your mission. So we as a crew can do any of the operations that any of the other crew members can do.
Hi, I'm Jack in second grade from Hawthorne Elementary.
Hi, I'm Adrian. I'm in the sixth grade at Hawthorne Elementary. Have you ever used a robotic arm?
I have flown the robotic arm, the Canada arm, a lot. During my first space mission, there was no control from the ground, and we flew it maybe two or three times every week. And as ground control has taken over a lot of the operations, astronauts, crew members on station, fly the arm for the critical things like grabbing a spacecraft coming up with cargo. But other than that, most operations are done through ground control.
Hi, I'm Griffith. I am in pre-K.
Hi, my name's Denali. I'm a fourth grader at Hawthorne Elementary. Me and Griffin had the same question. What is it like in space?
It is really neat to be in space. You can fly around the room like Peter Pan.
My name is Akil. I'm a third grader at Hawthorne Elementary. What was the hardest part of your training to become a NASA astronaut?
For me, the hardest part of becoming a NASA astronaut is learning how to speak Russian language, which is required right now as part of the International Space Station. And the cosmonauts all have to learn English. That, for me, as a technical uber geek, is the hardest part of being an astronaut.
Hi, I'm Frey, and I'm in pre-K in the Hawthorne Elementary.
Hi, I'm Bentley, and I'm in fourth grade in Hawthorne Elementary. Me and Frey had the same question. What is your favorite food to eat in space?
My favorite food while here on space station is called tvorog. It's a Russian food. It's a dairy product. We have no comparable product to that in the United States.
Hi, my name is Yalini, and I'm at Hawthorne, and I'm in fourth grade.
My question is, how long have you been away from Earth, and what is the first thing you want to do when you are back on Earth?
Well, for this mission, I've been here about 3.5 months. On other missions, their standard length is about 6 months. That's how long I've been here, and the first thing I'm going to do when I get back to Earth is probably go to the bathroom.
Hi, I'm Mog from 1st grade Hawthorne Elementary.
I'm Ryder from 4th grade in Hawthorne Elementary, and me and Mog had similar questions. How does it feel to sleep on the International Space Station?
How do you sleep on the International Space Station? One of my crewmates, Butch, he is a heavy sleeper, and he just happens to be here. Look at this. He's in his sleeping bag, and you get your sleep bag like this, and you can just float around, and look at this. He's such a heavy sleeper. He doesn't even know whether his head's in the sleep bag or out of his sleep bag.
My name's Grant. I'm in 6th grade at Hawthorne Elementary, and I was wondering, what is it like adapting to zero gravity, and does it make tasks easier or more challenging?
Adapting to zero gravity, some tasks are easier, like you saw when I was floating Butch around. I was just using my fingertips to do that. You can't do that on Earth because he's a big guy. So those tasks are easier, but the hardest tasks are dealing with a whole bunch of little tiny things, little pieces of paper, little tiny nuts and bolts, and they just fly all over the place. Where on Earth, you don't need to worry about that. They could just sit on the bench. And there goes Sunny. She was just flying all over the place, too, because we're in space and you can.
Hello, my name is Monica Neidiger, and I'm honored to serve as the principal at Hawthorne Elementary School in the Boise School District. Thank you to the educators and students across Idaho for working on and submitting your questions. Today, we've had the opportunity to see firsthand the dedication, perseverance, and teamwork that our astronauts embody. These are the same qualities you are developing in yourselves through your growth mindset, your curiosity, and your commitment to learning. On behalf of our Hawthorne community, thank you to our special guests we have in our audience today, as well as everyone else watching. Safe travels to everyone aboard the International Space Station, and we look forward to continuing this adventure of discovery and hope you will all join us.
Bye now. It was really fun answering your questions, and I want you all to go to school, study hard, and come and fly into space with me.
Station, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event. Thank you.
Copy that.
Thank you to all participants. Station, we are now resuming operational audio communications.